Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC697CPM790. I have one here powered up. I also have, if you notice to the right, I have a BEM713. And you may not be able to see that I have an extended rack to my right powered up with a BEM711. So what I have here is a IC697CHS750, 5-slot rack, the BEM711, CPM790, being powered by an IC697PWR711. I have the same rack and power supply to my right, and it has a BEM711 with an extension cable. So this is going to be required for the CPM790 in order to get this processor into run mode, which is our ultimate goal here. And so what I wanted to point out was just a couple things here. First of all, I have the door off to the CPM790 just so that you can better see that there's a little bit of glare to this door. So first thing, we have this powered up and I have an OK light. And as usual, if you don't have an OK light, or if your OK light is blinking and you don't have communication, that means that there's a problem with your processor and you won't be able to follow this test. So if that is the case, this is something that we do repair normally. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Okay, so now that I do have it powered up, I want to connect up to it. And I'm going to connect up to it using this cable. This is AS693232SNP serial cable. Okay. And you can't see, but I'm in Prophecy Machine Edition. So what I'm going to do here is go ahead and connect up to the controller using the lightning bolt icon, where now we're connected. And then using the handprint, we're going to go online into program mode. All right, now that we're there, next thing we're going to do on the top menu bar, we're going to go to Target, click Target, go to Online Commands. In the Online Commands window, we're going to go to Clear. And what you want to clear there is the controller and I/O fault tables, just the bottom two selections. Don't click on anything else. You don't want to clear any other information that you may need. That could be dangerous. So again, just the controller and I/O fault table. All right. So once that's selected, go ahead and clear that, and we're going to hit download and run, which is the download information and run button in one icon. Okay, so we're doing that now. And when it asks you what you want to build, you want to build the hardware configuration and logic. Nothing else. We don't want to put anything to permanent flash memory or anything like that. So select that. The build in progress. Our ultimate goal is to get this into run mode. And once we do, I'll show you two of the other features real quickly here. So, okay, we're in run mode now. All right. So the other two features, there are no other ports. There's just this one port, programming port. And then we have this toggle switch. Toggle switch is the output enabled run and module stop. So right now we're in run with outputs enabled. And now we are in run with outputs disabled. And now the controller is stopped. So those LEDs work. The toggle switch works. And then the last feature, of course, is the key. In the top, this is our memory protect switch, and we turn this on. The LED turns on to indicate that the memory is protected, telling us that that feature works, so we're okay with that. All right, so if this is a processor that you feel is giving you problems, what we recommend typically is to let the processor run overnight or over a weekend, couple days, and what you're hoping for is that the processor is still in run mode when you return. If for some reason it kicks itself out of run mode voluntarily, You want to go into Prophecy Machine Edition, go to Target, and one of the features there is Diagnostics. Click on Diagnostics, and your Info Viewer table will come up and tell you what the reason is that the processor kicked itself out of run mode. So if it's something that you're able to understand and get through, that's great. If not, sometimes the errors can be confusing to understand. And again, it's something that we look at here. We do repair. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products that we have in stock with same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.